Hello everybody and welcome to the WAW Performance Centre here in Norwich. I'm Matt Naismith, alongside me is Ryan Richards. How you doing, friends?
Good evening, it must be an absolute pleasure for you to have me here, ready for a top evening of top quality wrestling.
And let's get straight to the action. Over to our MC, it's Nemesis, it's Ben.
Welcome to the WAW Performance Centre, and welcome to WAW! For all of you suffering from our post-fightmare blues, we are here to cure that with our Academy show this evening. And also, I don't know if you've seen on our socials that the next Fightmare date has been posted. It is the 18th of November next year, so those tickets will be coming around very, very quickly, so keep your eyes out for those. Another Fightmare. Fightmare 5, huh? I know, but here we are with our Academy show, which we make the most of the rest of 2022, moving into 2023. The following contest is for the WAW British Heavyweight Championship. This match will be held over a time limit of 60 minutes and be decided by one fall.
Hyde has definitely got his game face on tonight.
He's definitely got his game face on. This is absolutely going to be huge. As it said on our package video, it's got to end. This feud is, it's not healthy for both. And it all stems when Kobe won the British Heavyweight Championship.
It's all about to end.
The alleged real British Heavyweight Champion and the Sky's the Limit briefcase winner.
So I think even if Oscar Hyde is unlucky tonight, he's still got that briefcase.
And how apt. Oscar's music for Winner Takes It All, figuratively and literally.
Indeed. Definitely in for a treat with this one.
I've not seen this before. You can hear the crowd is absolutely deafening.
Both these lads are out for blood.
There was no love lost. They absolutely hate each other.
Definitely tip things over the edge, the fact Oscar Hyde won that briefcase at Fightmare 4.
Is that made a return, the petition?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is for the WAW British Heavyweight Championship. This is a championship match. You gentlemen need to compose yourselves or this match will not start. Introducing first the challenger from Emerald City. He's the pioneer of the petition, Oscar Hyde! And standing opposite him today is the current reigning, defending WAW British Heavyweight Champion. It's Toby Nitro!
Look at Oscar, I have never seen him like that. He's like a wild animal, he's like a caged beast. This is frightening.
One of the referees out of the ring, please. One of the referees out of the ring.
I'm not gonna lie.
British wrestling.
I think they're both past caring about the British Championship. I think they just want to kick the absolute
you know what out of them. It's going to,
exactly.
It's not a wrestling match.
No,
this isn't a wrestling match.
This is
good.
Great.
This is a fuck. And I think both are going to reciprocate. Oh god. And likewise, I've never seen Kobe like this. He's normally so cool, calm, and collective. And oh, run of steel steps. As I've said 1,000 times, you poke the bear too many times, the bear will respond.
No. I can confirm that hurts.
That's hardly any. Oh, just a face plant right on the hardest part of the ring. Even our crowd are bloodthirsty. They want more. They love Kobe. They want him to decimate Oscar. Fireman's carry. T-bone suplex. Threw him halfway across the ring, all the way to the other side. Going for a stereo second suplex. The strength of Kobe is absolutely frightening. I mean, you've seen Oscar, and he's not a small man.
He must be seeing stars by now.
where he wants to see stars, but not the stars that he wants.
Using the referee to his advantage there.
I mean, he's got to be careful. He did physically hold him.
Oh,
what a leapfrog!
Massive crossbody to the outside.
Just taking themselves out. It looks like they're going to...
Oh, into the barrier.
I mean, I think maybe we should have had two refs in this match.
Probably would have been an idea.
Oh! Kobe taking the taste of his medicine.
He needs to be very careful here. The referee has got a 10 count going.
A double DQ, therefore Kobe would win.
That.
Oscar going for a suplex. Nicely done. That's probably the first proper wrestling move we've seen. And even that was done with such force.
You see the handprints coming up on Kobe's back already.
Nicely frog.
Oh.
Kobe, literally like a fish out of water, is stuck.
What could he be getting for here?
I don't know what he's trying to do.
It's a little bit different. No.
No.
Is he standing? Oh, God! On.
This could be one, two. Oh, Kobe barely, desperately got out of that. Kobe, what? What?
Larry's providing a distraction here. Oscar Hardy's got that championship belt.
He's got that.
No. What is he going to go for here?
What's he going to try and do here? No.
Oh.
Oh, oh, no, it backfired spectacularly.
And I think Larry Lee's just slightly regretting
one,
out here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2.
Oh, just a two.
So close.
The referee's then not quite sure why the belt was in the middle of the ring.
Oh, just picking him. Oscar, beautiful gut-wrench suplex. Affecting that lower back.
Another.
We're going for a third.
Oh, holds on.
Holding on desperately. Nice headlock takedown and just fists. Variation, looks like a variation of a camel clutch.
Oh.
Now he's got it on.
He's going to be feeling that one.
Middle of the ring, Kobe's got nowhere to go. He's got to either try and power out or use the height advantage to just reach the ropes.
Kobe,
think Kobe fade. Is he trying? Maybe getting some sort of segment. Oh. Nice counter.
Double leg takedown. Oh, going for that Boston crab. Bending Oscar in half.
Bending it.
Oh.
It's got all the pressure on that lower back.
In fact, it is very, very close to the ropes. Wouldn't take much for him to reach it. But is Oscar aware?
I think he just desperately trying to get anything. He's got all of Kobe's weight on him as well.
Is he going to make it, or is he going to have to tap?
He's desperately crawling.
And fair play to him, he's made it.
I have to give Oscar so much credit there. Anyone else, if they tapped, you would not blame them.
His back must be in bits.
They are both. This match is now. This is career changing for both of them. They're not going to be the same after this.
Absolutely not.
Monkey flip. Oh.
Some of the extremes they go into, this could easily be career ending.
This is so. This is what's worth it. This rivalry all to come to a head.
I'm sure they're both more than aware. Oh.
Face buster.
But there are weapons under that ring.
One, two.
I say if they were to go for a weapon, they know it'd be a straight DQ.
Be a straight DQ. I mean, I think the referee knows the importance of this. He's let a lot slide. And more out of necessity, really. Oh! Oscar trying to.
Nitro blocks. Oh, no.
Oscar's got caught. Desperately trying to get any sort of purchase. Slingshot. Oh my god, slingshot powerbomb.
Slingshot. Oh, into the referee.
Oh, we've got a referee out now. No.
Oh. And here comes the staff.
The staff.
Attacking Nitro.
Oh, come on, we need some security just to get this.
Oh!
No!
And that backfired. Double suplex straight into Oscar.
Oh, they're out. No, nothing to do with me.
They're legging it.
10 minutes gone.
But whatever the case, Kobe's out, Oscar's out, the referee's back on his feet gingerly. Dueling forearms, just trying to get any sort of offense. Oh!
Oh! Oh,
just so. Even the referee thought that, felt that as well. Another forearm, clubbing blow. I mean, they've both given each other, they've gone toe to toe. Whatever Kobe's given, Oscar's given back.
They are both going to be red raw after this.
One song is slam, that's it. One,
two,
no!
Did you just say that?
I thought that was a very, very long two. I thought that was it. Oscar thought that was it.
Oscar managed to pick up Kobe Nitro for a world's strongest slam, and Kobe kicked out.
I mean, the referee might have been still trying to get his senses. I mean, he's trying the best he can, but wow, that was the closest in this match we've got for a decisive winner. Now Oscar's going all in. Gonna take a massive chance. Cross body. Oh,
Kobe,
what strength! Wow! Hoist him up for a fireman's carry. TKO! That has to be it. One, two,
three. Look.
You got the two. That was a two.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 minutes, 48 seconds of wrestling, your winner and still WAW British Heavyweight Champion, Kobe Nitro!
Well, the referee,
I'm not going to lie, that looked like Oscar kicked out.
I mean, I'm not one to... whatever the case now, it's official. Kobe Nitro has retained his British Heavyweight Championship. Whatever the case, we need to congratulate Kobe on retaining. But what an effort on the part of Oscar. Kobe offering his hand.
Self coming out with the tails in between their legs.
I mean, potentially maybe they cost Oscar his huge chop.
Costa might regret that.
Double DDT for his trouble.
His head. Oh no. Oscar's going to be even more trouble. No?
Kobe cleared house.
That's not what I was expecting. Kobe offers the hand again. Oh no. Going for the briefcase.
I mean, huge things for Kobe again to extend the hand. The crowd wants to see this happen. No, Oscar's still not reciprocating. There goes the petition.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it again for your winner and still WAW British Heavyweight Champion, Kobe Nitro! The following contest is for the WAW World Tag Team Championships. This match will be held over a time limit of 60 minutes and be decided by 1-4. Can we bring out the challengers, please?
And here we go, it's main event time. The World Tag Team Championships.
Here come the number one contender. Staff will be seen on numerous occasions tonight.
This is a match we've seen so many times.
The staff, of course, represented by Lady Bella Vanderbilt. There's Mr. Haywood and Sir Ryan Matthews. Concentration and focus on their face.
It's a massive opportunity. They could walk away tonight as world champions.
And the champions, please.
Here we are, the WAW World Tag Team Champions, newly crowned. Very, very engaged with the crowd, but is this going to be their downfall tonight? Are they more focused on the crowd than they are the match?
Introducing first the challengers. Firstly, the butler, Mr. Haywood. His tag team partner is the legal counsel, Sir Ryan Matthews. Together they are Lady Bella's boys, the staff! And their opponents. They are the new WAW World Tag Team Champions. So Eli, the Battlekats! Take the belts, referee, please. As is customary in a world title belt, we will now have the national anthem. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. May the best team win.
This match is such importance as well. The pair, each team, have such storied history. They've wrestled each other in singles contests and numerous tag contests throughout their careers. It's almost paralleled. It's all come to this.
It's a massive, massive match for both teams.
Shake hands,
neither teams want to shake hands.
Head to head, toe to toe.
Chris Wrestling.
I think this is going to be not so much wrestling in this one.
Nice little assist.
Very
clever. Oh, see, right on the button. Springboards.
Double dive cross caught by the staff. Takes him down.
Great double team there. No, referee caught right. Not going to count, but I think the Cats wanted that. Atomic drop.
That was
kick
low.
To the left. What a table take. Watch out, Sir Ryan. Great save there. That could have been there. That we're going to be near, I think.
Oh, and they have got the belts. That is just going to annoy the Cats. Fairness, it suits them.
Well, they haven't won it.
Not
referee
yet.
Referee bars will start the count.
Definitely. Oh, what the Battlekats going for here? Oh,
nice little fake.
That's a little bit awkward.
Good fake out, though. Oh, double baseball slide.
Oh! Oh, don't damage the belts, they're new.
Well, the Cats aren't going to damage, they've only just won them. So, Sir Ryan and I believe Battlekats. Small package. One, two.
It's the two count.
Springboards again. See what I mean? That they know each other so well. They're countering each. Both giving it each other as well. Springboard. Miss.
Oh, nice reversal there. Massive power slam from Sir Ryan.
A good dynamic in this match. Both the Battlekats and Sir Ryan all like to be very fast paced. May like to use aerial moves. The odd one out is Mr. Hayward. He's a lot more of a power game. And as he was a former rugby union player, he's definitely got the muscle and the upper body strength.
I'd argue Sir Ryan likes to use the power and strength as well. I say the Battlekats have always been very high flyers, very fast pace.
Yeah, I can see what you mean. Maybe I've been able to say that all three of them, Battlekats and Sir Ryan, are the same size. But Mr. Hayward has definitely got them. They're bigger, stronger. Nice front face lock.
Oh, body slam.
Huge slam. One. Typical staff double team behind the ref's back.
Referee don't see it.
You are right. Oh, massive knee right into the mask of.
Surely, technically, if the referee doesn't see it, you're doing nothing wrong.
No, if the referee didn't see it, then it didn't happen.
Oh, looks like that Saran slipped. It's just, unfortunately, it was his boot right into Battlecat Sam's face.
Took his head off. This could be it. One, two. Sunset flip. What a clothesline.
Oh God, they are that's got to be a closed fist.
Well, they're cats, already it'd be closed paws.
Surely that is still against the rules. But again, the referee doesn't seem to want to know.
Buster. Out. There's the tag.
Hulo comes in. The House of Fire taken down to right. Matthews.
Nice single leg drop kick.
Baseball slide.
Oh! Backstabber.
Eli seems to hurt his leg there.
Maybe just needs to just get some blood back into it. Might have just gone numb just temporarily. Nice crossbody. One, two.
Sir Ryan, forearm to the chest.
Finds carry. Release the Moen drop. Nicely done. Middle of the ring. Another pin. One, two, loads of quite a few near falls on the staff's part. The cats are on the back foot.
The staff definitely have the upper hand here. Could the cats be waving goodbye to their world tag team titles?
Incredibly short reign.
I mean, they would have their rematch, but it's not something such a big achievement you just want to lose. Tag to Mr. Hayward.
I mean, if you remember, it was the staff that, well, assisted in getting the Cats the world title win. They interfered in their match. They were attacking RKJ and Brett. But the Cats obviously had no idea that they were doing that. It's So is this all along? Is this like shenanigans that they'd rather have faced the Cats rather than...
Quite possibly. Mr. Hayward... No, with the mask of Eli there.
Well, grinding the mask is the same as grinding the hair.
I think he was trying to undo the ties. Big suplex.
Nice little flip over to get into a pin. The ring move.
Sam pulls Eli out of the way. Outside interference.
Go for the enziguri, missed.
Oh, elbow drop to the back. I think Eli's definitely starting to struggle here.
He's using him as a cushion just to soften any sort of blow.
Oh,
wow, what an enziguri. Stabber into a destroyer. Both down. If they attempt to a 10 count, that would mean the Cats would win, retain their titles, excuse me.
So Brian pulls Sam off the edge of the apron.
Oh, tittle.
Oh, it's straight into the post.
Mr. Hayward has received his first public warning.
I think that was Sam's shoulder that went straight into the ring post there.
Certainly feeling it.
Oh. They are not soft, they are solid, solid steel.
Oh, double, just taking themselves out. This means to have the World Tag Team Championships for both the Cats and the staff.
This can go easily either way at the minute.
Either way, and in a way as well, both really deserve. They've given absolutely everything, and then they're going to then spoil it by doing just blatant rule breaking.
Again, you've got your public warnings. Why not use them?
Springboard, standing moonsault, beautifully done.
Tag to Sam. Double line.
Double back elbow, keep up.
The staff are possibly in trouble here. Still having clotheslines in the corner.
tried every other strategy. You just take them both out. Drop kick bulldog combo.
Minutes gone.
Quarter of an hour already gone.
Both teams are giving everything here.
Cats go for the
superplex.
Superplex. This usually means the splash.
Hayward breaks up the pin.
Using our referee well as a springboard. I mean, to be even after me, you can't blame Mr. Hayward for that.
So we're not having a tug of war
with the belts. After all, there is a match going
on. Corner roll there.
One, two.
I think the belt collided with Sam's head there.
I think you're right, it did. I mean, there's a pin. No, one, two.
I mean, I think that was genuinely an accident for Mr. Hayward there.
I mean,
but
I don't think he realised because he was too busy. Referee saying one of them needs to go out. They're both, they'll take each other out.
The referee is losing control here majorly.
His arm wide, just let them fight then. Oh.
The end of the day, yes, we want to see a genuine result, but there needs to be a level of control here.
There was a pedigree. I think that must be it. Surely, just got to try and get
push
the
him pin. Over.
One, two.
Oh. Sam breaks that
I
one
think
up.
Just.
That was extremely.
That was way too close to call.
Oh, that could have.
2.99 out of 100.
I'm not going to lie. I thought that was a 3 to start with. I think we need VAR for that one.
Well, unlike other sports, we don't have VAR, we don't have the instant replay or challenges in the referee's decisions final. That was a very close 2, but a 2 nonetheless. Huge face plant. Staff say this is it. Double DDT spiked right on his head.
Oh, just a 2.
Hayward's face tells the whole story. He looks like he's just seen a ghost.
He cannot believe it. The staff wondering, what have we got to do?
I mean, he's out on his feet. I
don't think Eli even knows where he is at the minute after that.
Got him in an electric chair position.
Down his back. Oh,
spinning enziguri.
Oh,
double super kick.
Oh. And
that's
the Battlekats retain.
After 18 minutes, what a match. Your winners are still WAW World Tag Team Champions.
What a match. I've said that could have easily gone either way.
Either way.
So the staff was so close to taking that.
got to give the credit to all four. They gave each other everything and then some.
The look on Mr. Hayward's face, cannot believe it.
I know, it's such a shame.
Trust that Ryan Mack has even got to his feet yet. Oh, here we go. So Ryan Mack just dropped to his knees. He can even keep himself on his feet.
Amazing show we've had here tonight.
It was absolutely fantastic.
Thank you so much for having us.
Well, that concludes our academy.
Thank you for having me. We'll see you very, very soon for even more WAW action. I've been Matt Naismith.
I've been Ryan Richards. It must have been a pleasure to have me.
We'll see you very, very soon.